Okay, guys, so in this lab, we are going to do the extra lab RDS. In this lab, we will create a VPC with two public subnet and two private subnet. So I'm going to access AWS there. And this is will allow me to create the VPC. So the first thing I will do is to go to the VPC. And in the VPC, I will create an Elastic IP. So this is going to be the Elastic IP that I have in front of me. So now I will do the first thing, which is after creating the Elastic IP, I will create a VPC using the VPC wizard. Let me call this lab VPC. It's going to be the same default IP address. So this is going to be 10.0.0/16 for the VPC, and for the first subnet, it's going to be in the first availability zone with the name public subnet 1. For the private subnet, it's going to be in the same availability zone with the private subnet 1 as well, and then select the Elastic IP and create a VPC. Normally, this will take a few minutes to load. The next step will be to create public subnet 2 and the private subnet 2 in the second availability zone. Then I will launch a web server and I will launch as well an RDS. So let us wait now for this to finish. So now the VPC is ready. So back to my diagram there, I need to have in that lab VPC, I need to have two more subnets. So I'm going to make sure in the lab VPC, I have public subnet 1 and private subnet 1. Then I create a subnet, select lab VPC, call this public subnet 2. And this is going to be in the second availability zone with the available IP that I have, which is 10.0.2.0/24 and create. In the same way, I will create the private subnet. So this is going to be private subnet 2 in the second availability zone. And the IP address, as I explained in my diagram, is going to be 10.0.3.0 as well, and then create subnet. Now I could verify I create all I need in the lab VPC by selecting the VPC column and sort. So I have public subnet 1, private subnet 1, public subnet 2, private subnet 2. So I should move now to the route table. In the route table, I have two route tables. One is lab VPC with main equal yes. And if you go to the routes, there is two routes here, one for the local, any IP is going to an AT dash, and this is the NAT gateway. Then we have another route table with main equal no. And if you check the routes, this is going with any IP going to the IGIDW, which is the internet gateway. Going back to this, I'm going to select the private route table with main equal yes, and I will rename it to private route table, create. Now in the subnet association, edit, and then I will associate only the private subnet with it, so save. Then I go to the second route table where main equal no, and I will edit this because this is my public route table. Subnet association, edit, and I just need to add the public subnet to it. Now I have two subnets associated with each route table. I could verify this by the explicit subnet association column. The next step is going to be to launch a web server. So if you go back to my a diagram, you have a web server, but as well, we have a web security group in it. So let me go now and create a security group. So I'm going to create the security group. I will call it web SG. This is allow access to HTTP. Now this is where most students make mistake. They keep the default, which is the default VPC, but we want it to be in lab VPC. Add rule, and this is will be HTTP. Because it is a web server, it's going to take traffic from anywhere. You could add basically both rules for IP4 and IPv6. It also good to have them and save. Because I'm here also, I would like to create the security group for the RDS. So let me create RDS SG, allow access to RDS. Again, this is going to be in lab VPC. I add the rule and this is will be MySQL Aurora port. Now here in the custom, I want only the security group that coming from the web security group to access this server. So I'm going to save. And now let me go and create the EC2. So I'm going to launch a new EC2. That's going to be a Linux Amazon 2. And this is will be T3 Micro. Choose lab VPC. If you look into my diagram, I want it to be in lab public subnet 1. Don't forget to make sure to put auto assign public IP to enable. And now let us look to the script that I gave to you in the lab sheet and paste that script here. Add storage. Now add tag. Let me call this guy here web server. Configure security group because I have already created a security group. I'm going to select web security group, review. I don't want port 22 to be open. Acknowledge and choose existing key, a key which is going to be the Vocarium key, and launch. I will keep the web server now launching and I will move quickly to the RDS. In the same way in the RDS, we have two things before we start the creation of the RDS to create. We need to create a security group and we need to create a subnet, a group. Now we have done the security group creation, so we are left only with the subnet a group. So we're going to create a new subnet a group. I will call this DB subnet a group. And just here, DB subnet a group. Now this is going to be in lab VPC and I only want it to be in the two availability zones, 1A and 1B. Now be careful here because you need to select the right subnet. Remember these going to be 10.0.3 and 10.0.1. So I'm going to click here 10.0.1 and 10.0.3. If you are not sure, you could go here and go to the VPC and go to the subnets and make sure you are basically working on the right subnet. So this is private subnet 1, 10.0.1. Private subnet 2, 10.0.3. So these are the same two subnets that I have. And now create. So this is the DB subnet group. Now I go to the dashboard, create a database. And this database is going to be MySQL. Dev test, I'm going to call it lab. One or extra lab, maybe just to distinguish this between this one and the lab we do. Now the username, I will keep it admin, and the password, I'm going to use the same password we use for our labs, which is lab-password. Lab-password, and then it will be a burstable one with T3 micro. Without any auto scaling for the storage. Now this is going to be in my lab VPC using my DB subnet group, and I want to remove the default security group and I choose the RDS security group. And in the additional configuration, I want to make sure that this is the right port. Don't change the port name, guys. And call this the DB name as lab. Remove enable automated backups and encryption and enhanced monitoring. And the last thing I want to do is just to create the database. Now this is will take 4 minutes to finish the creation. Now let me go back to my EC2. And in my EC2, I want to make sure that I can see the demo application that I have, or the lab application that I have there. So the lab application is ready. All I need now is to provide the endpoint, database name, the username, and the password, similar to what I did configure in my RDS. So let us now wait for this to finish. So I'm going to pause the recording for a few minutes. Now the database is available. So if you go to the extra lab, you can see there is an endpoint. So we are going to copy that and we put it in the endpoint text field. Now the name of the database, if you forget what's the name of the database, you will find it here, lab, in under DB name. So I'm going to put this lab. And as well, the username that you use is also here, admin. And you remember all that I use lab password. You could also basically go and test this if you want. If you forget the password, you can change it using the modify. So you can see now I managed to connect to the database, so everything is fine. I could add just demo Mac. This is just testing that I have me at me.ie and submit. So just to test that I can read and write to the DB, and that's all for this lab. Thank you for seeing this video.